La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا هل أدلكم على تجارة من عذاب أليم؟ تؤمنون بالله ورسوله وتجاهدون في سبيل الله بأموالكم وأنفسكم، ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. يغفر لكم ذنوبكم ويدخلكم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ومساكن طيبة في جنات عدن، ذلك هو الفوز العظيم. صدق الله العظيم. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: إنكم على بينة من ربكم، ما لم تظهر فيكم سكرتان، سكرة الجهل وسكرة حب العيش، وأنتم تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتجاهدون في سبيل الله. فإذا ظهر فيكم حب الدنيا فلا تأمرون بالمعروف ولا تنهون عن المنكر ولا تجاهدون في سبيل الله. والقائلون يومئذ بالكتاب والسنة كالسابقين الأولين من المهاجرين والأنصار، أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Respected ulama ikram, elders, that exists is the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu khaliqu kulli shay. Allah has created everything. And in this creation, in this takhliq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is khaliq, Allah is musawwir, Allah is Bari. Ulama explain what is meant by this is that there was no fashion, there was no plan, there was no copying someone else's creation. Allah created uniquely, Allah created on His own. And more than this, Bari, insan, when he has to prepare something, insan, when he supposedly creates something, he requires raw material. And from that raw material, he is able to create or prepare or present something. Allah in His creation, Allah created from no raw material. There was no substance and then Allah used that substance to create, but Allah created from nothingness. The first cow was created from nothingness. The first human being was created from nothingness. The first hen was created from nothingness. Everything Allah brought into creation without there being any substance, without there being any raw material. لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا وَمَا تَحْتَ الثَّرَى. To Allah belongs everything in the heavens, everything in the earth, everything between the heavens and the earth, everything beneath the earth. Everything belongs to Allah. Everything for it to come into existence, for it to remain in existence, for it to be utilized for whatever purpose it is being utilized, and for its existence to terminate also. Every second it is totally, completely dependent on the qudrat, on the power of one Allah. Ala inna lillahi ma fis samawati wa ma fil ard. Ala inna lillahi man fis samawati wa man fil ard. Every cell in our bodies, every atom in this universe is existing on the qudrat, on the power of Allah. It is benefiting on the power of Allah. It is harming on the power of Allah. And this is iman. That conviction and that reality has to enter into the heart, that whatever happens, happens on the amr, on the order of Allah. A person is seeing, we say he is seeing with his eyes. He is hearing with his ears. He is grasping with his hands. He is walking with his feet. Something happens, this person is now dead. A dead corpse is in front of you. The eyes are there. You said he saw with his eyes. Now it cannot see. The ears are there, you said it was hearing with its ears, now it cannot hear. The hands are there, you said it was grasping with its hands, the hand, it cannot grasp. The feet are there, yet it cannot walk. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they ask you about the ruh, they ask you about the soul. قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي Tell them that the ruh is from the amr of my Allah. That person was not seeing with his eyes, he was seeing because Allah's amr and order was there for him to see. He was not hearing with his ears, he was hearing on the amr and the order of Allah. He was not grasping with his hands, he was grasping on the order of Allah. He was not walking with his feet, he was walking on the order of Allah. Allah is alone, there is no partner with Allah. Every benefit originates from Allah. Every harm originates from Allah. Every circumstance originates from Allah. No human being, no creation is doing anything of its own accord. إِنَّ الْقُوَّةَ لِلَّهِ جَمِيعًا Every power belongs to Allah. The entire creation, لَا يَمْلِكُونَ لِأَنفُسِهِمْ ضَرُّ وَلَا نَفْعًا وَلَا يَمْلِكُونَ مَوْتًا وَلَا حَيَاتًا وَلَا نُشُورًا Cannot benefit, cannot harm, cannot give life, cannot give death, cannot resurrect. They are not living of their own accord, they are not dying of their own accord, they are not existing of their own accord, and their existence will not terminate of their own accord. وَهُوَ الَّذِي فِي السَّمَاءِ إِلَهِ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَهِ Allah is the ilah of the heavens, Allah is the ilah of the earth. There is only one planner, one giver, one maker, one taker. مَا يَفْتَحِ اللَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ رَحْمَةٍ فَلَا مُمْسِكَ لَهَا If Allah makes decision of mercy, no one can withhold this. وَمَا يَفْتَحِ اللَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ رَحْمَةٍ فَلَا مُمْسِكَ لَهَا وَمَا يُمْسِكْ فَلَا مُرْسِلَ لَهُ مِنْ بَعْدِ And if Allah takes away the decision of mercy, then no one can bring that mercy. يَمْسِسْكَ اللَّهُ بِالضُّرْ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُ If Allah decides that a nation has to suffer, no one is going to remove that calamity. وَإِن يُرِدْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَلَا رَادَّ لِفَضْلِهِ If Allah decides that a nation is going to prosper, then no force, no government, no superpower can take away the prosperity of that nation. It is not the currency, it is not the economy, it is no government. There is only one government, one force, one system, one benefit, one harm, and that is Allah. And He is alone. Allahu la ilaha illa hu. There is no ilah besides Allah. Alif lam mim. Allahu la ilaha illa hu. Allah says, I am alone. Shahid Allahu annahu la ilaha illa hu. Allah gives gawah, Allah gives witness Himself that there is no one besides me. Mudabbir bila mu'in, mudabbir bila mushir, mudabbir bila wazir. He is the planner, He is the arranger, He is the controller. There is no assistant with Him, there is no advisor with Him, there is no minister with Him. Laysa ma'ahu ilahu yukhsha, wala rabbu yurja, wala hajibu yursha, wala waziru yurta. There is no other ilah besides Him that has to be feared. There is no other Rabb upon whom there can be hope. There is no doorkeeper with Allah that you have to go through to reach Allah. There is no minister or government official that you have to bribe to get unto Allah. He is alone. يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ From the heavens to the earth, the arranger and the controller of everything is one Allah. He introduces himself like this, إِنَّ رَبَّكُمُ اللَّهِ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامِ ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ يُغْشِ اللَّيْلَ النَّهَارِ يَطْلُبُهُ حَثِيثًا وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ وَالنُّجُومَ مُسَخَّرَاتٍ بِأَمْرِهِ أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرِ تَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah says, your Rabb, who is your Rabb? Your Rabb is Allah that has created the seven heavens and the seven earths. Then He rose upon His arsh. يُغْشِ اللَّيْلَ النَّهَارِ. Look around you, night follows day. You have taken these things for granted. Allah says, قُلْ, say unto them who have fakhr, who have pride, who have arrogance over their science, who have arrogance over their technology, who have arrogance over their weaponry, who have arrogance over their governments, who have arrogance over their numbers, say unto them, إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ اللَّيْلَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِضِيَاءٍ. If Allah made the decision that the sun is not to rise, it is to remain darkness, it is to remain night, from now till Qiyamah, which scientist, which government, which army, which technology, which force is going to bring daylight for you? قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ النَّهَارَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِلَيْلٍ تَسْكُنُونَ فِيهِ. Say unto them, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in your arrogance, in your pride, you have defied Allah, you have turned your back on Allah, you have forgotten your Allah, you have not subjugated and lowered yourself in front of one Allah who is the controller of everything. Say unto them, if Allah caused it to remain daytime from now till Qiyamah, if Allah ordered that sun, stay, do not set, which ilah, which qudrat, which force is going to bring night time for you so that you may rest in that night? And that also, Allahu alladhi yursilu riyaha, this earth, it says 24,000 miles, diameter of this earth, 24,000 miles long. And this earth is not still. This earth is spinning, all the time spinning on its axis. And not spinning at 1 mile per hour or 2 miles per hour. This earth is spinning at 1,000 miles per hour. Every hour this earth is spinning. That is why it takes 24 hours for it to finish one cycle. 24,000 miles, 1,000 miles per hour. And moving outward also. Spinning on its own 1,000 miles per hour. And moving outward also 65,000 miles every hour. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا وَالَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ ذَلُولًا أَمَّنْ جَعَلَ الْأَرْضَ قَرَارًا وَإِلَى الْأَرْضِ كَيْفَ سُطِحَتْ. Again and again Allah in His Quran says, look at the earth, how we spread it out for you. No bulldozers were used, no tramplers were used to flatten this earth and spread it out for you and make it this shape. Allah says, we made it a qarar, a shelter, a place of rest. We made it a cradle. Allah says, mihada, we made it a cradle. Perhaps in that time, when these ayats were revealed, they couldn't understand what it was referring to. Take a bicycle wheel and spin it. Leave 1,000 miles per hour, spin it at 10 miles per hour. Not a dust particle will remain on that bicycle wheel. This earth is spinning at 1,000 miles an hour, and yet we are sitting comfortably on the surface of this earth. And moving outward 65,000 miles per hour. Whose system? Whose nizam is this? Allah invites you, look around you, see. 1,000 miles per hour, so day is 12 hours, night is 12 hours. If that speed instead of 1,000 miles per hour had to be 2,000 miles per hour, then the day would be 6 hours and the night would be 6 hours. By the time in the traffic you get to work, it will already be time to come home. And when you get home and go to sleep, it will already be time to go back to work before your eyes close also. And if Allah Ta'ala had to cut that speed, instead of 1,000 miles per hour, make it 500 miles per hour. Then the day will be 24 hours long and the night will be 24 hours long. You'll work and work and work till you are finished. Then you'll come home, how long are you going to sleep? 12 hours, 13 hours, 14 hours, 24 hour long night. Allah Ta'ala knew in what there is benefit for His banda and His slave. Which scientist set the speed of the earth? Which technology set that speed? It's a different matter that science today tells us that if the day had to be 24 hours long, then the surface temperature of the earth would increase to such an extent that everything on this earth would become parched. And the night was 24 hours long, and the surface temperature of this earth would decrease to such an extent that whatever else survived the day would die in the night. But for the benefit of the banda, for the benefit of his slave, Allah has said this like this. And then Allah challenges, tell them, if it has to be daytime forever till Qiyamah, which ilah, which qudrat, which force is going to bring nighttime for them? If it had to be nighttime from now till Qiyamah, which ilah, which qudrat, which force is going to bring daytime for them? Yughshil laylan nahar yatlubuhu hatitha. Day enters upon night, each one following the other. Yulijul layla fin nahar, yulijul nahara fil layl. Allah enters the night into day, the day into night. Today the date may be 20th of May. This morning, on the 20th of May, in the year 2000, the sun rose at approximately 6 or 7.45 or whatever it may be. 1,000 years ago, 1,000 years ago, on the 20th of May, the sunrise was exactly at the same time. And 1,000 years from now, if this universe is still existing, Allah's Qasam, the sunrise will be exactly on the same time. Which clock was being used? Whose system, whose nizam is this? وَالشَّمْسُ تَجْرِي لِمُسْتَقَرِّ اللَّهَ ذَلِكَ تَقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ. This is the nizam of Aziz and Alim. The one who is almighty, the one who has complete knowledge, his nizam, his system. وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ وَالنُّجُومَ مُسَخَّرَاتٍ بِأَمْرِهِ. The sun is in his qabza, the moon is in his qabza, the stars are in his qabza. يُمْسِكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ أَن تَزُولَ. The heavens cannot move, the earth cannot move without the permission of Allah. These are Allah's makhluk, these are Allah's creation, they are under his control. The sun is not giving off heat of its own accord, the moon is not giving off light of its own accord. It is said that the surface temperature of the sun is 12,000 degrees Fahrenheit. The core of the sun is 27 million degrees Fahrenheit. Every second, Allah's sun is giving off energy equivalent to 1 million atom bombs. Every second. 1 million atom bombs is being given off every second. And like this, it is carrying on for thousands and thousands and thousands of years. Have we ever heard that one pipe is blocked? Have we ever heard that some pipe has to be changed? Have we ever heard that the sun has to be oiled or some engineer has to go and sort it out? Allah's nizam is without defect. It is continuing on the amr, on the order of Allah. That 1 million atom bombs of energy is being given off every second. Insaniyat would be burned to ashes. Allah set the distance, 93 million miles, so that if the light of the sun had to be divided, if the energy of the sun had to be divided into 20 million parts, one part is coming to this earth. And if from the one part it had to become two, all of us would burn to ashes. Which scientist said this? Which technology said this? وَهُوَ الَّذِي فِي السَّمَاءِ إِلَهِ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَهِ. Allah is the ilah of the heavens. Allah is the ilah of the earth. One controller, one maker, one sustainer, one nourisher, one giver of life, one giver of death, one giver of health, one giver of sickness. Everything happens on the irada, on the qudrat, on the will of one Allah. One Allah is doing. تُعِزُّ مَن تَشَاءُ. Izzat on the irada, on the desire of Allah. وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. Allah gives zillat, disgrace to whom He wants. يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah gives hidayat to whom He wants. يُضِلُّ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah deviates whom He wants. مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ كَانْ كَمَا شَاءَ كَانْ فِي الْوَقْتِ الَّذِي شَاءَ عَلَى الْوَجْهِ الَّذِي شَاءَ مِنْ غَيْرِ زِيَادَةٍ وَلَا نُقْصَانٍ وَلَا تَقَدُّمٍ وَلَا تَأَخُّرٍ وَمَا لَمْ يَشَأْ لَمْ يَكُنْ. That which Allah wants will happen. It will happen in the time Allah wants. It will happen in the manner Allah wants. It will not happen before Allah wanted. It will not happen after Allah wanted. It will not happen more than that which Allah wants. It will not happen less than that which Allah wants. And that which Allah doesn't want, all the forces of this earth can get together, it will never happen. One giver, one taker, one maker, one breaker. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Inna lillahi ta'ala malakan nisfuhu al-asfal min nar wa nisfuhu al-ala min thalj. La-thalju tutfi'un nar wa lan-naru tudhibu thalj." Allah has created one angel. The bottom half of this angel is fire. The top half is ice. The ice does not put out the fire. And the fire doesn't cause the ice to melt. This is Allah. Allah doesn't need circumstances. Allah doesn't need means. Musa alayhi salam, in the lap of Firaun, looking at that child, he says, "Innahu qatili." This is the one that's going to kill me. This is the one that's going to take away my kingdom. He knows it. The sword is raised. But Allah's sifat of Hafiz, Allah's quality of protection was with Musa alayhi salam. In the lap of the enemy, he could not harm one hair on the head of that child. And he had to pay for the upbringing of that child. Knowing my kingdom is going to go on his hands. This is Allah. Yunus alayhi salam, in the stomach of the fish, Allah sustains. Ashab al-Kahf, the youngsters of the cave, وَلَبِثُوا فِي كَهْفِهِمْ 300 وَازْدَادُوا 309 years. 309 years in the cave. Try and go to sleep. Sleeping. Youngsters sleeping. How long can you sleep? 12 hours? 14 hours? 16 hours? 18 hours? 20 hours? The back will start paining. The head will start paining. The feet will start paining. The bones eventually will start cracking. 309 years Allah gave them sleep. And when they wake up, وَكَذَلِكَ بَعَثْنَاهُمْ لِيَتَسَاءَلُوا بَيْنَهُمْ قَالَ قَائِلٌ مِّنْهُمْ كَمْ لَبِثْتُمْ قَالُوا لَبِثْنَا يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ. When they wake up, they start asking one another, how long did we sleep? One says one day, one says a portion of one day. No force on this earth can stop the movement of time. Try and stop time. Allah says, time is my makhluq. Time is my creation. Huwa al-awwal, wal-akhir, wal-zahir, wal-batin. Awwal bila bidaya. Allah is the first without a beginning. Akhir bila nihaya. Allah is the last without an ending. Awwal bila makan. Allah is the first, not confined to space. Akhir bila zaman. Allah is the last, not confined to time. Space, Allah created. Time, Allah created. 20 or 25 year old youngster, when he goes into the cave, 309 years later, does not come out as a 334 year old youngster, comes out still as a 25 year old youngster. That till the door of the cave, Allah ordered time must continue. In the cave, Allah ordered time to stop. This is Allah. We haven't understood who is Allah. And this angel is making tasbih of Allah. Bottom half fire, top half ice, perpetually in tasbih. What tasbih? Before we say what tasbih, what is tasbih? Take tasbih and say, subhanallah, 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 subhanallah. That is why there is no change coming in us. You know, elders are saying, sit twice a day and make 100 times tasbih, third kalima. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. What is meant is the tongue mustn't say it, the heart must also say it. The tongue is saying, the heart is not saying. Ask someone, what is subhanallah? He says, glory be to Allah. Translation. Glory be to Allah. They explain, farsh se lekar arsh tak, from the earth, beneath the earth, whether it is the minerals, whether it is the iron ore, whether it is the gold, whether it is the diamond, whether it is the silver, whether it is the multitudes of creation Allah has kept beneath the earth, whether it is the oceans, whether it is the millions and billions of creations Allah has kept within the oceans. In fact, the other day they say in one cubic centimeter of water, Allah has kept more living organisms than the population of the whole world. In one cubic centimeter of water, Allah has kept more than 6 billion organisms. or whether it is all those creations of Allah, whether it is the trees, whether it is the birds, whether it is the insects, whether it is insan, whether it is jinnat, whether it is the malaika, whether it is the heavens, whether it is the comets, whether it is the planets, whether it is the asteroids, whether it is the first heaven, malaika of the first heaven, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, whether it is the kursi of Allah, whether it is the arsh of Allah, farsh se lekar arsh tak, from the earth right up to the arsh of Allah, everything that exists has some blemish, some fault, some weakness, some shortcoming in it. O Allah, you are the only being that is free from any blemish, any fault, any shortcoming. Subhanallah, glory be to you, O Allah. I declare your purity from any shortcoming. That is tasbih. And not the tongue must say it, the heart must say it. When the tongue does not move with the invitation of Allah, when the tongue does not call to Allah, when is the heart ever going to call towards Allah? When is the reality of Allah's azmat ever going to enter into the heart, when the tongue does not speak of Allah? Ask the businessman, talk about your business, he'll talk 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, till you have to tell him to sit down and keep quiet. Ask the college student to talk about his degree, ask the farmer to talk about his agriculture, ask a parent to talk about his child, ask the person selling onions to talk about the onions, ask the dairy man to talk about his milk and his sour milk and whatever else he is producing. Each one for hours and hours will be prepared to talk about that. Ask them now, talk about Allah. Talk about that Allah that has created everything. 1 minute will pass, 2 minutes will pass, he'll still be silent, then he'll say that mujhe sharam aate hai, I am embarrassed to speak about Allah. This riwaj has come out. This consciousness has come out that I have to speak about Allah. When the tongue will not move with the remembrance and the dawat of Allah, how is that body ever going to move in the obedience of Allah? When the heart does not beat with the love of Allah, how is that body ever going to sacrifice itself for Allah? This is zulm. This is oppression. That dawat of onions is being given. Look around us. Someone has got this product written on him. Someone has got that product. Everything around us, dawat. Dawat of every khair of Allah is taking place. Yet the ummah that was sent to call to Allah is not calling to Allah. We are calling to everything else. Our elders say, we are not saying to you, we are not saying to you that speak of Allah's greatness, Him the glory of Allah. We are not saying to you so that this becomes a means by which you prepare someone for 40 days or 4 months. Am isliye kehte hai, ke Allah ke barai bayan karo, kyunki ye Allah ka haq hai ke uske tarah na kiya jaye. We are saying to you that speak of the greatness of Allah, invite to Allah, call to Allah, glorify Allah, because it is the right of Allah that He has to be glorified. It is the right of Allah that He has to be glorified. Makhlooq ka zikr bimari hai. To talk of the creation is a sickness. To talk of the Creator is the cure of that sickness. This insan was said, Ama inni lam akhlukkum liastakthira bikum min qilla, wala liasta'ina bikum ala amrin qad ajastu an, wala liasta'nisa bikum min wahsha, innama khalaqtukum litabuduni tawila, wa tadhkuruni kathira, wa tusabbihuni bukrata wa asila. Allah says, I did not create you. I did not create you because we numbered few and we wanted to increase our numbers. I did not create you because we were lonely and we wanted some company. I did not create you because there was some task that is too difficult for me to do and I wanted helpers to carry it out. إِنَّمَا خَلَقْتُكُمْ لِتَعْبُدُونِي طَوِيلًا وَتَذْكُرُونِي كَثِيرًا وَتُسَبِّحُونِي بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. I created you so that you hymn my praises. I created you so that you glorify me. I created you so that you serve me. I created you so that you subjugate yourself to me. Insan's purpose, insan's maqsad, insan's object on this earth, Allah's qasam, is not degrees, is not jobs, is not amassing of wealth. Ye sab zaruriyat hai. All these are necessities. Insan's purpose is to make the marifat of Allah, to recognize Allah, to invite. One is to recognize Allah, and during the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we were given one to worship Allah. Together with that, we were given safarat. We are the representatives of Allah on this earth. We are Allah's safir. We are Allah's messengers. No other ummah said, Ana Rasulu Rasulillah. I am the Rasul of the Rasul of Allah. Besides this ummah was sent as the messengers of the Messenger of Allah. This ummah was sent as the messengers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to do what? To build shops, to compete with the kuffar for what they are competing for, to make valuable the temporary dunya. No, my beloved brothers, this ummah was sent for what Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent. Inna arsalnaka shahidaw wa mubashshiraw wa nadira wa da'iyan ila Allah bi iznihi wa sirajan munira. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we sent you as a witness, as a giver of glad tidings, as a warner, as a da'i to Allah, as an inviter to Allah. And we sent you as a shining lantern. This ummah was sent for what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was sent. We are inviters to Allah. We have to tell our children that my purpose is I am a caller to Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We have to tell that wife that this is my purpose. We have to go to the whole mankind. We have to go to every person and call them to Allah. Dawud alayhi salam, ayyu ibadika ahabbu ilayk. Allah, which of your slaves do you love the most? Dawud alayhi salam asked Allah, Allah, which of your slaves do you love the most? Allah says, taqiyul qalb, naqiyul kaffain, la ya'ti ahadam bisu, wa la yamshi bin namima, تَزُولُ الْجِبَالُ وَلَا يَزُولُ أَحَبَّنِي وَأَحَبَّ مَنْ يُحِبُّنِي وَحَبَّبَنِي إِلَى النَّاسِ. Ajib. Allah says, those whom I love, they are those in whose heart is my taqwa, my fear, reliance only on Allah, motivated only to please Allah. They don't stretch their hands out to anyone besides Allah. They don't harm Allah's creation. They don't carry tales. They remain firm in the obedience of Allah. Mountains will move, they will not move. Then Allah says, they love me. They love me. They love those who love me. And they make me beloved in the hearts of men. Dawud alayhi salam says, Inni uhibbuk wa uhibbu man yuhibbuk fa kayfa uhabbibuka ila an-nas. Allah, I love you. I love those that love you. I want to become your beloved. How can I make mankind love you? How can I make mankind love you? Allah Ta'ala tells him, ذَكِّرْهُمْ بِعَلَائِي وَنَعْمَائِي وَبَلَائِي. O Dawood, go from person to person. Go from person to person. Tell them about Allah. Tell them about my favors. Tell them about my bounties. Tell them about my majesty. Tell them about my glory. This ummah is called, ordered, sent, chosen by Allah to go from person to person. Tell them who is Allah. We are Allah's safir. We are Allah's messengers on this earth. We have been sent to make ta'aruf of Allah, to invite and introduce the whole of mankind to who is Allah. That Allah who is the maker, that Allah who is the breaker, that Allah who is the giver, that Allah who is the taker, that Allah who is alone. Allahu la ilaha illa hu, al-hayy, al-qayyum, la ta'khudhuhu sinatu wala nawm. Allah, who is alone, He is alive, He is the controller of everything. He is the only one that exists on His own accord. Everything else exists because of Allah. La ta'khudhuhu sinatu wala nawm. He does not sleep. He does not get tired. He does not doze off. His doors are open. The nightfall descends. The courts are closed. The palaces are closed. The gates are locked. Locks are put on. Doorkeepers are placed. Now it is after hours. The kings are in their reveling. The kings of this world are in their enjoyment and their haram and their filth. They are not prepared to entertain anyone. They are not prepared to listen to anyone. La ta'khudhuhu sinatu wala nawm. Allah yanzilu rabbuna تبارك وتعالى حين يبقى ثلث الليل الآخر فيقول من يدعوني فأستجيب له من يسألني فأعطيه من يستغفرني فأغفر له. At the time when everyone else is sleeping, in ghaflat, in negligence, Allah in His majesty, in His glory, descends to the first heaven, and Allah calls out in the last third of the night, who is there to call unto me? Who is there that has some need that I may grant his need? Who is there that wants something so that I may grant it to him? Who is there that wants my forgiveness so that I may forgive him? Allah, who is not in need of us, who doesn't need us, yet He is calling out, who is there? مَنْ ذَلَّذِي قَرَى عَلَىٰ بَابِي فَلَمْ أَفْتَحْلَىٰ Who is there that knocked on my door and that door was not open for him? مَنْ ذَلَّذِي سَأَلَنِي فَلَمْ أُعْطِهِ Who is there that asked from me and was not granted? Such a giver, that if he doesn't give you in dunya, he will give you so much in akhirat that you will wish he didn't fulfill any wish of yours in dunya. لا تسألن بني آدم حاجة وسل الذي أبوابه لا يغلق فالله يغضب إن تركت سؤاله وبني آدم حين يسأل يغضب Don't ask your needs from insan. Don't ask your needs from insan. Ask your needs from the one whose doors never close. Insan is such, the more you ask him, he will get angry with you. Allah is such that he gets angry when you don't ask from him. This is Allah. Abdi, Allah Ta'ala addresses his slave, in ذَكَرْتَنِي ذَكَرْتُكْ وَإِن نَسِيْتَنِي ذَكَرْتُكْ When you remember me, I remember you, and when you forget me, I still remember you. Ya Dawood, O Dawood, لَوْ يَعْلَمُ الْمُدْبِرُونَ مَا عِنْدِي مِنَ الْأَشْوَاقِ لَتَقَطَّعَتْ أَوْصَالُهُمْ If those who had turned away from me, if those whose days are spent in my disobedience, if those whose nights are spent in my disobedience, if they had to come to know how much of shock, how much of love, how much of muhabbat, how much of anticipation and affection I have for them, then their joy will be such that their limbs will split. O Dawood, if that is my love for those who have broken my orders, what is my love for those who are obedient to me? That is Allah. يبن آدم إني لك محب فبحقي عليك كن لي محبا Allah says, O insan, O my banda, O my slaves, I love you. Now because of the haq, because of the right, what right Allah doesn't have on us, every breath of air we take in is the deen of Allah upon us. Every blink of this eyelid is Allah's deen upon us. Every movement of this tongue is Allah's favor upon us. Now Allah says, because of the haq that I have over you, kun li muhibba, you also love me. Go from person to person, introduce them to who is Allah. Tell them about Allah's greatness. Tell them about Allah's majesty. Tell them about Allah's glory. They will begin to love Allah. Allah Ta'ala says, Dawood alayhi salam, in return for that, I will love you. This ummat are the safir of Allah. Invite us to Allah. Coming back to what we are saying, this angel is making tasbih of Allah. What tasbih? Subhana man allafa bayna al-thalj wan-nar. Glory be to Allah. Glory be to Allah who has created harmony between fire and ice. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells his sahaba of this, immediately he makes dua for his ummah. Immediately. Why his heart was so attached to his ummah? Everything was given for this ummah. His day was for the ummah. His night was for the ummah. Once, Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha says, I woke up one night and I perceived that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not there. It was her turn. She was a human being. And women will be women. Never mind their status and their rank. She said, the thought entered my mind that perhaps has he not gone to one of the other wives. So she says, I stealthily crept out of my home to see where he is. And she says, I looked around, I walked in the streets till I found him at the graveyard of Baqi in Madinah Munawwara. And he was standing there making dua to Allah for the residents of those graves. She says, I approached him, he heard. She says, I went back. When Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam returned, he could hear the heavy breathing of Aisha radiallahu anha. So he asked her that, oh Aisha, where have you been? She admitted the truth and she said that this is what I suspected, so I came out to investigate. He looked at her and he told her that, oh Aisha, a Nabi of Allah will never deceive anyone. A Nabi of Allah is not Ghaddar. A Nabi of Allah does not deceive anyone. Oh Aisha, I went to the graveyard to make dua for my ummah that are buried there. She said, oh Nabi of Allah, make dua for me. At this juncture, make dua that Allah forgives me. So he said, that Allahumma ghfir li Aishata. Oh Allah, forgive Aisha, all her past sins and all her future sins. She was elated, overjoyed, that, oh Nabi of Allah, you have made such a dua for me. He looked at her elation and her joy, and he told her that, oh Aisha, once I made this dua for you, you have become so happy. Allah's qasam, every day, 5 times I make this dua for my ummah. Such love, such attachment, that Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu comes and says, oh Nabi of Allah, where will I find you on the day of judgment? Where will I find you? His maqam, his status. One sahaba is sitting and talking. One of them says, Adam alayhi salam was the chosen of Allah, a human being, the chosen of Allah. The other one says, Musa, also a human being, the one whom Allah spoke to, Naji of Allah, who used to whisper to Allah. Another one says, Isa alayhi salam, also insan, yet he was the ruh and the kalima of Allah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard this conversation. He comes in the presence of his sahaba, سَمِعْتُ عُجْبَكُمْ وَكَلَامَكُمْ. I heard what you were discussing, and I heard your surprise over that. إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلُ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ كَذَلِكَ. Ibrahim alayhi salam was the friend of Allah. There is nothing to doubt or be surprised about. وَآدَمُ صَفِيُّ اللَّهُ وَهُوَ كَذَلِكَ. Adam alayhi salam was the chosen of Allah. Nothing to be surprised about. وَمُوسَى كَلِيمُ اللَّهِ. Musa alayhi salam was the one whom Allah spoke to. وَإِيسَى رُوحُهُ وَكَلِمَتُهُ وَهُوَ كَذَلِكَ. And Isa alayhi salam was the ruh and the kalima of Allah. And that is a fact. And then he said, now listen, Allah wa ana habibullahi wa la fakh. I am the beloved of Allah, and I do not say this with any pride. Wa ana hamilu liwa'il hamdi yawm al-qiyamati wa la fakh. I will be the one on the day of judgment who will raise the flag of the honor of Allah, and I do not say this with any pride. Wa ana akramul awwalin wal akhirin yawm al-qiyamati wa la fakh. I will be the most honored of insaniyat of mankind on the day of judgment, and I do not say this with any pride. وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ مَنْ يُحَرِّكُ حِلْقَةَ الْجَنَّةِ فَيُفْتَحُ لِي وَأَنَا أَدْخُلَهَا وَمَعِي فُقَرَاءُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا فَخْر. I will be the first to knock on the door of Jannat. Ridwan will call out, مَنْ بِالْبَابِ. Who is at the door? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will reply, Muhammadur Rasulullah. Muhammad, the sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger of Allah. Immediately he will say, I have been ordered not to open until you come. And then only the door will be open. The honor of Allah, I will be the first who will knock at the door of Jannat. I will be the first to enter. With me will be the poor ones of my ummah. With me will be the fuqara of my ummah. Let the whole mankind till Qiyamah, let all those who have measured success, who have measured honor, who have measured status, who have measured dignity on the temporary, deceptive and worthless wealth of this world, understand that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, with me will be the fuqara of my ummah. Those who were poor and in that poverty obeyed Allah, they will enter Jannat first with me. And I do not say this with any pride. Ana awwalun nasi hushuran. I will be the first to be raised up on the day of judgment. When mankind is silenced, when mankind has lost hope, when mankind is caught in the grip of fear, ana mubashshiruhum idha aisu. I will give them glad tidings at a time when they will be in the height of despair. قَائِدُهُمْ إِذَا وَفَدُوا When they are gathered, I will be their leader and their representative in front of Allah. وَشَفِيعُهُمْ إِذَا أُنْسِتُوا When everyone is silenced, each one will be fearing for himself. Each one will be saying, Nafsi, Nafsi. So that Isa alayhi salam also will say, La asaluka ummi Maryam. Oh Allah, I don't ask you for the jannat of my mother Maryam also. Save me from Jahannam. When that halat and that condition will be such, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ No mother will want to know her child. No father will want to know his child. No husband will want to know his wife. When Allah's jalal and Allah's anger and Allah's qahar will be of such a level, one human being with the call of ummati, ummati, Allah my ummat, Allah my ummat, will go in front of Allah and will fall into sajda, and that sajda will last 7 days. And he says, I will praise Allah in a manner in which Allah has never been praised. I don't even know the words of that praise. At that time, Allah will put it into my heart. La uhsi thanan alayk anta kama athnayta ala nafsik. Allah, we cannot praise you as you ought to be praised. You are as you have praised yourself. I will praise Allah in a manner no one has ever praised Allah.
For all your CD needs, contact Simtek Islamic CDs 031-304-6165 or 082-500-9111. Simtek Islamic CDs, manufacturers and distributors of Islamic audio and media CDs.
O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, raise up your head. Ask, you will be granted. Seek intercession, your intercession will be accepted. Then also, he will not ask for Fatima. He will not ask for Hassan and Hussein radiallahu anhumah. He will not ask for himself. He will not ask for his family. He will ask for his ummah. Such attachment with the ummah. That Anas radiallahu, his maqam and his status on that day, we can see from all these riwayats. Such that a mimbar will be brought. A mimbar will be brought for him. He will not sit on the mimbar. Why? He will say to Allah, that Allah, I fear if I sit on this mimbar will transport me immediately into Jannat. And how can I go into Jannat when my ummah has not been guaranteed protection from Jahannam? So he will place his hand, on the pulpit of that mimbar and hold on to it. He will not sit on that mimbar. One shayir and one poet says, with reference to the ayat of the Quran, from which we can understand his status, Musa Kalimullah, when he goes to Koh Tur, the mountain of Tur, to meet Allah, to speak to Allah, as he is approaching, such is his anticipation and love for Allah, that in the last stages he starts running. Musa alayhi salam is asked, that why did you run? He says, Ajiltu ilayka rabbi litarda. Oh my Allah, I hasten so that you may become happy with me. Ajiltu ilayka rabbi litarda, so that you become happy with me. For Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى Allah will give you and give you and give you so much till you become happy with Allah. One shayin says, when we read this ayat, وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى سُرَّ قُلُوبُنَا Our hearts were filled with joy because we knew Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would never be happy وَوَاحِدٌ مِّنْ أُمَّتِهِ فِي النَّارِ while there is still one ummati of his in Jahannam. Allah says, I will give you till you are happy. So we knew that every one of his ummat will eventually be safe from Jahannam. That maqam, that status on that day. And yet Anas radiallahu anhu asks him, where will we find you on that day? He says, oh Anas, you will either find me at the Hawz-e-Kawthar giving water to my ummah, Oh, you will find me at the mizan, at the scales where the deeds are being weighed. I will place my hand on the pan of the good deeds of my ummah so that the weight increases. Oh, you will find me at the bridge of Sirat, the bridge over Jahannam, which each person has to pass over. Once Abu Darda radiallahu anhu, Ghaliban Abdullah bin Rawaha radiallahu anhu, is lying with his head in the lap of his wife, and he begins to cry. She, looking at him crying, she starts crying. Their hearts were very, very soft. So he asked them, "Are you keek? What is causing you to cry?" She says, "I saw you crying, this is why I started crying." He said, that ذَكَرْتُ قَوْلَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَىٰ, I remember the ayat of the Qur'an, wherein my Allah says, وَإِمْ مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا كَانَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَقْضِيًّا, that every one of you will have to cross over Sirat. Every one of you will have to cross over the bridge over Jahannam. This is a decision which Allah has decreed and will never change. No exclusion, no istisna, no one will be excluded from this. He says, I thought of this ayat of the Quran and the fear came into my heart, what will happen if I slip and fall into Jahannam? O Anas, you will either find me at Sirat saying, Rabbi Sallim, Sallim, Rabbi Sallim, Sallim, O Allah have mercy, O Allah have mercy. Had ahadith, akhbar, incidents or promises mentioned in Quran and hadith were did not enter through one ear of sahaba and come out of the other ear. These were realities to them. This is why their hearts were moved and their hearts were affected. Like the sahabi starts crying just thinking of the bridge of Sirat. That the day is going to come when I will have to cross this. Why? Because Allah says. Through his beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is a reality, that bridge will have to be crossed. Why effort on iman was made? Then the reality of iman entered into the hearts. And not only sahaba, the generations that followed also. Women also. Today the husband goes from the home to the shop. So when he's leaving for the shop and the job, the wife calls out from behind, I need onions in the house, I need potatoes, I need this, I need that. She places all her taqazas of dunya, that bring all this back for me. And then from the shop, he goes back home. So when he enters the house, she knows where he is coming from. So immediately her first expectation is to see, has he fulfilled my needs of dunya? Has he carried out my wishes? That is why if you go to a home of a person and ask the wife, knock on the door and ask that, where is so and so? She says, he's gone to the bazaar, he's gone to the shop. How long will he be? She says, I don't know. Maybe he'll hear of one parcel somewhere else, or he'll hear of one deal somewhere else, or one auction somewhere else, or something else will come up. And he will be gone there. I don't know when he'll come back. Why? Because that type of environment. Sahaba, when they would leave from the home, they would go to the masjid. From the masjid, they would take the taqaza and the demand of deen by coming into the environment of the masjid. And from the masjid, they would go to the business. And from the business, they would come back to the masjid. By going from the masjid to the business, they would go to the business with the fikr of the masjid. So sitting in the business, they would not look at the customer that walked in with this eye, that if he has come here to spend 10 rand, and in paying for that 10 rand goods, he takes out a 100 rand note, how can I convince him to give me the other 90 rands also? He will not look with that eye, but he will have the conviction in his heart that my risk is already decreed by Allah. And if I am supposed to get 100 rand today, if he gives me 10 rand, the other 90, whether I sit here, whether I don't sit here, whether I open the shop or I don't open the shop, will come to me, because Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, by the qasam of that being in whose hand lies my life, like your moth will chase you, your risk will chase you. So if he has gone with the figure of the masjid, he will look at this person who walks into his shop. He has come from the environment of the masjid, environment of hidayat. So his eyes will fall on this person, that is he on hidayat or not. Today the person will come into the shop from head to toe in 5 or 10 or 15 ways, he is breaking the order of Allah. Our only fikr will be how we can take his dunya from him. The fact that in the disobedience of Allah is halakat and destruction for this person, that perception or thought will not enter into the heart also. Why? Because we have went from the home with the taqaza of home. How many men have went into haram because of the demands of their wives? Why? Because their minds have not been made. Those days, the husband is leaving the home because he is going to the masjid, and the fikr of the masjid, he goes to the shop. From the shop, he doesn't go home, he comes back to the masjid. And then from the masjid, he goes home. So the wife knows, my husband is coming from the masjid. Immediately, what did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam teach you? The fikr was different. The soch and the zehn and the thinking of those women was different. This is why when you would go to the home of a sahabi and ask, where is so and so? If she said that he is gone to the bazaar, when will he be back? He's gone there, he'll be back just now. But if the answer is given that he is gone to the masjid, he's gone to the masjid, then the question is asked, when will he come back? She says, she will reply, I don't know. Perhaps there is some jamaat that has to go in the path of Allah. Perhaps there is some taqaza of deen. Immediately I know my husband, without looking left, without looking right, without needing to take the permission of the home minister, will understand, I have been sent for deen, so he will fulfill that taqaza. That is why, when the husband is leaving the home to go to the business, the wife will call out from behind, comes in the riwayat, إِيَّاكَ وَكَسْبِ الْحَرَامِ فَإِنَّا نَصْبِرُ عَلَى الْجُوعِ وَلَا نَصْبِرُ عَلَى نَارِ جَهَنَّمِ. Beware of bringing haram into my home. Beware of bringing haram into my home. I can make sabr on hunger. I will never be able to make sabr over the azab of Jahannam. That reality, consciousness of akhirat was there. Even in the women of those times. That is why, and the generations after that also, Rabia Adawiya rahmatullah alayha, each night she would go to her husband and ask his permission, that do you have need for me? If the answer was no, then the whole night would be spent in ibadat. When her husband passes away, no lesser a personality than Hassan Basri rahmatullah alayhi, the wali of his time, sends proposal for her. When he sends proposal for her, she replies with four questions. That, oh Hassan, oh Hassan, tell me that when the time comes for me to leave this dunya, will I leave with the kalima la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah on my lips or not? He said, I don't know. Second question, when the questions of the qabr and the grave are presented to me, will I be able to give the answer or not? Today when the proposal comes, what is the bank balance of the suitor? What type of house has he got? What type of furniture has he got? Will he keep my daughter in luxury? Will he fulfill her worldly needs? This is the only fikr. Is he on deen? Or is he not on deen? إِذَا خَطَبَ إِلَيْكُمْ مَنْ تَرْضَوْنَ دِينَهُ وَخُلُقَهُ فَزَوِّجُوهُ إِلَّا تَفْعَلُوا تَكُنْ فِتْنَةٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَفَسَادٌ عَرِيدٌ. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when a proposal comes from a person whose deen and akhlaq satisfies you, give your daughter in marriage to him without consideration for anything else. If you do not do so, there will be fitna and fasad on this earth. That is what emanated from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and what the West and what the enemies of Allah and what this dunya teaches us is that will she be in luxury or not? Abu Darda radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, Yazid, who is the Khalifa, ruler of two continents of this earth, sends proposal for his daughter, he sends back rejection. One of the ordinary staff of Yazid says to him, that, O Khalifa, you have received this rejection of your proposal, give me permission to propose. In anger he says, do what you want to do. This person proposes, Abu Darda accepts and gets his daughter married to this person. There's an uproar. He refused the king, he refused the ruler and gave an ordinary pauper. The message comes, Abu Darda, how did you insult Yazid like this? He said, I did not insult Yazid. I thought of the day my daughter would be sitting on the throne, around her would be eunuchs, someone would be combing her hair, someone would be seeing to her every need, she would be in the lap of luxury. On that day, where would her deen be? On that day, where would the akhirat be? For the fear of what would happen to the akhirat of my daughter, I turned down that proposal. Their fikr was different. Their thought was different. Their thinking was different. Why? Because they were not motivated by the desire of dunya. Today, dunya has become a reality. That which Quran and that which Allah says is ghurur, is a deception, we have made that reality. And that which Allah, وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ, worship your Allah until yaqeen comes to you. Mufassireen are unanimous when the Quran uses the word yaqeen, which means absolute certainty. Quran is referring to maut. Allah says, worship your Allah until yaqeen, maut comes to you. That which Quran, that which Allah says is reality, to us that has become deception. And that which Allah says is deception has become reality. That is why the janazah will be going. Four people will be carrying the janazah on their shoulders. We'll be gathered in crowds and hordes around the house of the janazah. Walk past and listen to what conversation is taking place. The picture of reality is in front of our eyes and we are still talking about the deception. Why? Because we have made such an effort on dunya, such an effort on a deception, that deception has become reality. Once a person was eating in the graveyard, Hassan Basri looks at him and he says, you are a munafiq, maut is in front of you and you still have the desire for food. Once a janazah is going past, somebody asks Abu Darda radiallahu anhu, whose janazah is that? He says, bhai, that is your janazah. And if you don't like what I am saying, it's my janazah. Because Allah says, إِنَّكَ مَيِّتُ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ, you have to die and they have to die. That is the reality. Today that has become a deception to us. Why? Because so much effort on dunya, that our thinking is dunya, our concern is dunya, our worry is dunya, the basis on which we measure success is dunya. Ye sab batil hai. This is batil. The source of this is batil. That knowledge which emanated from the arsh of Allah, and that knowledge which emanated from Allah, and that knowledge which 124,000 Anbiya alayhimu salatu wassalam brought to this earth, one after the other, generation upon generation, century upon century, has declared that to measure success on wealth and possessions is a deception. And today, we have defied all that and has accepted that which is opposite to that. Not with the tongue, but our actions speak for themselves. Allah's decisions will not be on verbal lip service. Allah's decisions will be on a'mal and on sifat and on qualities. O Hassan, when the questions of the grave are put to me, will I be able to reply them or not? O Hassan, on the day of judgment, وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَيَقُولُ هَا أُمُقْرَأُ كِتَابِيَهِ إِنِّي ظَنَنْتُ أَنِّي مُلَاقٍ حِسَابِيَهِ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَهِ فِي جَنَّةٍ عَالِيَهِ قُطُوفُهَا دَانِيَهِ كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا هَنِيئًا بِمَا أَسْلَفْتُمْ فِي الْأَيَّامِ الْخَالِيَهِ. On that day, the books of deeds of some will come into the right hand. They will say, come, how mukra'u kitabiya, come read my book. I knew of this day. He will be in happiness. He will be in joy. It will be said, eat, revel, enjoy, drink, everything is yours. وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِشِمَالِهِ فَيَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أُوْتَ كِتَابِيَهْ وَلَمْ أَدْرِ مَا حِسَابِيَهْ يَا لَيْتَهَا كَانَتِ الْقَاضِيَهْ مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيَهْ هَلَكَ عَنِّي سُلْطَانِيَهْ خُذُوهُ فَغُلُّوهُ ثُمَّ الْجَحِيمَ صَلُّوهُ ثم في سلسلة ذروها 70 ذراعا فاسلكوه. The book of Psalm will come in the left hand. He will say, يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أُوتَ كِتَابِيَهْ. If only I was not given this book. وَلَمْ أَدْرِ مَا حِسَابِيَهْ. And I did not know what my hisab was. يَا لَيْتَهَا كَانَتِ الْقَاضِيَهْ. If only I had died and was not resurrected again. مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيَهْ هَلَكَ عَنِّي سُلْطَانِيَهْ. My strength, my kingdom, my wealth, everything is gone. Nothing is helping me today. خُذُوهُ, grab hold of him. فَغُلُّوهُ, tie him up. ثُمَّ الْجَحِيمَ صَلُّوهُ, and then throw him into Jahannam. He said, oh Hassan, on that day, the books of deeds of some will go in the right hand, and the books of deeds of some will go in the left hand. On that day, will my book of deeds come into my right hand. And oh Hassan, on that day, when insaniyat will have to cross over Sirat, will I be able to cross, or will I fall into Jahannam? To all four questions, he sent back the reply that I do not know. She sent back the reply that I cannot accept your proposal because I have to make preparation for that day. Why akhirat had become a reality? Such effort we are making on dunya, that dunya has become our reality. All the time fikr, concern, worry for this temporary dunya. One sahabi comes to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he says, إِنَّكُمْ فُضِّلْتُمْ عَلَيْنَا بِالْأَلْوَانِ وَالصُّوَرِ وَالدِّينِ أَرَأَيْتُ إِنْ آمَنْتُ بِمَا آمَنْتُ وَعَمِلْتُ بِمَا عَمِلْتُ أَكُنْتُ مَعَكَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. He says that you, referring to the Arabs, have been given superiority over us by virtue of your lineage, by virtue of your wealth and your position. A black sahabi he was. He says, tell me, if I bring iman like you have brought iman, and I do amal like you are doing amal, will I be with you in Jannat? One fikr, one concern, one worry, akhirat. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells him, لا يهمك سواد وجهك إن آمنت بما آمنت وعملت بما عملت لكنت معي في الجنة وإن بلاطك الأسود ليرى من مسافة ألف عام. Do not let your complexion or your worldly position bother you. This is not of importance. If you have brought iman like I brought iman, and you do amal like I am doing amal, you will be with me in Jannah. And not only will you be with me, Allah will give your face such nur that it will be seen from a distance of 1,000 miles. Only criterion is deen. Criterion is deen. Criterion is akhirat. This dunya is a deception. Such an effort was made upon sahaba kiram till this reality had come into their hearts. Maybe. This angel makes tasbih. سُبْحَانَ مَنْ أَلَّفَ بَيْنَ الثَّلْجِ وَالنَّارِ. Glory be to my Allah, who has created harmony between fire and ice. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's connection with his ummah was so great, immediately he makes dua. Allahumma, كَمَا أَلَّفْتَ بَيْنَ الثَّلْجِ وَالنَّارِ أَلِّفْ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِ عِبَادِكَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Oh my Allah, oh my Allah, as you created harmony between fire and ice, unite the hearts of my ummah. Unite the hearts of my ummah. That Allah who created harmony between fire and ice will unite the hearts of this ummah. Why? Inna quluba bani adama bayna usbu'aini min asabi ar-Rahman. The hearts of man are between two fingers of the fingers of Rahman. يُقَلِّبُهُمَا كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ. Allah will turn those hearts in any direction He wants. But that decision is dependent on deen. That decision is dependent on amal. Nabi Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, constantly, all the time, this was the fikr. How can the hearts of my ummah be united? To this extent, lengthy riwayat, we've heard it over and over again. where that camel ran to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, alqa bi jarranihi fajarjara hatta btalla al-ard, started crying until a puddle of mud formed at its feet, at the feet of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He tells the Sahaba, this camel has come to complain of the ill treatment it is receiving from its master. Just then the owner comes. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, will you fulfill my wishes? He says, I am ready. May my parents be sacrificed upon you. He says, give me this camel in my possession. The camel is given. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to the camel, go, you are free. Faragha raghwatan. He lets out a sound. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Ameen. Thumma raghat thaniya. Again, Ameen. Thumma raghat thalitha. Again, Ameen. Thumma raghat rabia. Fabaka Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Three times the camel makes a sound. He says, Ameen. Fourth time he starts crying. Sahaba asks, what did this mean? He says that the camel has made dua. May Allah free you from your fear as you have freed me from my fear. I said, Ameen. May Allah protect your ummah from being completely annihilated by a tyrannical ruler. I said, Ameen. May Allah protect your ummah from being completely annihilated by some earthquake or by some natural disaster. I said, Ameen. The fourth dua, may Allah protect your ummah from breaking up into groups, breaking up into creed, breaking up into nationalities, breaking up into factions, breaking up into tribes, breaking up and disuniting. He says, Jibreel has come to inform me that this dua will not be accepted. And he started crying. This hurt him so much that this ummah, 23 years of effort was made to make them an ummah. لو أنفقت ما في الأرض جميعا ما ألف بين قلوبهم ولكن الله ألف بينهم. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you spent all the wealth of this earth, you would not be able to unite their hearts. But Allah is the uniter of the hearts. But decision of unity comes on amal. They were a broken people. Each one was not talking to the other. Centuries of hatred, centuries of enmity, centuries of fighting. If this one's camel had to go into that one's yard, then finish, he would kill that person, his son would kill him, and it would carry on. They would drink the blood of one another. Such hatred they had for each other. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent among such a people whose hearts were disunited. Disunity on the basis of language, disunity on the basis of color, disunity on the basis of creed. Disunity, this is his group, this is that person's group. And he made an effort. Understand, my respected brothers, that till Qiyamah, this ummah will never be unified. This ummah will never be made into an ummah on any other effort, on any other way, on any other movement, on any other call, on any other invitation, besides that which Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made that effort upon Sahaba. There is no other way. If this ummah could be united on anything else besides the tarteeb and system and effort of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah's qasam, He would have showed us another way. Call as much as we want to, shout as much as we want to, raise whatever slogans we want to raise, do whatever we want to do, but understand, I am sitting on the minbar, Allah's qasam, till this ummah does not make that same effort, this ummah will only be united on Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and that which emanated from Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, on nothing else. That is why on Hajjatul Wada, he said, تَرَكْتُكُمْ عَلَى الْمَحَجَّةِ الْبَيْضَى لَيْلُهَا كَنَهَارِهَا. I have left you on one clear road. Night is clear, day is clear, there is no ambiguity. 23 years of effort was culminated where Sahaba, this was instilled in them, that above race, above creed, above ideals, above nationality, above language, each one has to have the fikr and the cry and the concern for one insan to be saved from Jahannam.
To this extent, يُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا, that if they were in the depths of hunger, they would still give their brother preference over themselves. كُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانًا, all of you become brothers. On what? This ummah was united on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the warrior Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And then when this ummah turned its back on the effort of iman, and when this ummah turned its back on the warrior Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we cease to remain an ummah. Ummah is not a slogan. Ummah is not a title. Our elders tell us, ummah mukhtalif tabaqat ka wo majmua hai jinki maqsad ek ho. Ummah is a collection of different groups, different nationalities, different creeds, different ideals, whose maqsad, whose object is one. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. There has come to you a Rasul from amongst yourselves. His love for you is such, when you are hurt, he is hurt. And then Allah outlines, حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. He has hirs, he is haris, avaricious, desirous for you. For what? Mufassirin explain, ay ala hidayatikum. His ulama explain, what is hirs? They say when the desire, when the wish, when the tamanna, when the zeal, when the enthusiasm, when the cry for one thing becomes so great that it overrides everything else. More important than his family, more important than his wives, more important than his daughter, more important than his home, more important than his own life. Was, oh Allah, give my ummah hidayat. Here's for the hidayat of this ummah. For this he was ready to give everything. Everything was given. His daughters were given talaq, he tolerated that also. 3 miles in Taif, they pelted him. Stones would fall, blood was, understand, blood doesn't just spurt like that. One stone has to hit, second, third, fourth, fifth on the same spot before the flesh starts splitting. They pelted him mercilessly, he fell down. They picked him up, Mu'arrikheen write, to force him to carry on running so that they can carry on pelting. The land of Taif cried, the sky of Taif cried, Dajjatil Malaika, the Malaika cried. Till blood was pouring from the body of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For what? Hirs for hidayat. My ummah must get hidayat. One fikr. For this he gave everything. His home was emptied. The wealth of his wives were given. To this extent that there was no food in their homes also. His wives went hungry. His sahaba went hungry. Their wives became widows. Their children became orphans. Himself he says, لَوَدِدْتُ أَنِّي أُقْتَلَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ أُحْيَا ثُمَّ أُقْتَلْ ثُمَّ أُحْيَا ثُمَّ أُقْتَلْ ثُمَّ أُحْيَا. I want to die in Allah's path. Be given life. Give my life again. Be given life. Give my life again. One after that I will lay down my life. For what? Insaniyat must be saved from Jahannam. Mankind must be saved from Jahannam. So much fikr. Sahaba said, Daim al fikri wal ahzan. He was always in fikr, always in worry, always concerned, heart always crying with one concern, the ummah must get hidayat. And when Sahaba came onto that more important than my home, more important than my family, more important than my business, more important than my wealth, is the worry of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Allah's name must be raised on this earth, and Allah's orders must come alive on this earth. When they came onto that, Allah's help came to such an extent that Wasila bin Asqa, radiallahu ta'ala, who says, in the battle of Sham, we were 1,000, enemy was 100,000. He says, "Kunna kan nuktatil bayda fi jildil thawril aswad." You were like the strand of white hair on the body of a black ox. 1,000 against 100,000. Ma kana shiaruna illa an qal. All we did was, he said, "Ya Rabb Muhammad, unsur ummat Muhammad." O the Rabb Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, help the ummat of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They were an ummat. Today we are not an ummah. Today we are colors, we are creed, we are ideals, we are different goals. Until the object is not one, Allah's qasam, the hearts will not be united. They were an ummat. Abdullah bin Umar says, in farajat fis samai furja, the sky split open, horsemen started coming down, they had turbans tied on their heads. They said, abshir ya ummat Muhammad, faqad atakum al-nasr. Become happy, O the ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The help of Allah has come. The help of Allah has come. Why they were an ummat? He couldn't tolerate that the gaze should go in any direction besides the one goal, one direction, one fikr. To this extent that he didn't even allow deen to become an obstacle. Sahaba are returning once from the path of Allah. A sahabi sees a beautiful stream with some fresh grass next to it. Desire comes in his heart, I'll get a few sheep, I'll tend them here. From now till I die, I will worship Allah. Nothing wrong with that intention. Nothing wrong with that intention. But it would take him away from the overall object of the ummah. So he goes to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, first let me take mashura from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Lengthy riwayat. He goes and indicates his wishes. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, O my sahabi, لَمَقَامُ أَحَدِكُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ قِيَامِهِ فِي بَيْتِهِ سَبْعِينَ عَامًا. One moment you will spend in the path of Allah with my fikr and the worry for this ummah is better than 70 years of salah spent in your home. He did not allow them to look in any other direction. Their gazes were one. The whole 124,000 gathered on the plains of Arafat. Asa Allah talqani ba'da ami hada. Perhaps after this year you won't see me anymore. How they must have been affected. He gives his khutbah and then he gives the message. Fal yuballigh shahidukum ghaibakum. Oh my sahaba, take my message to the four corners of the earth. One, shirat for hidayat. Only fikr, how an ummah can be prepared that will have the worry of insaniyat in its heart. Today, this is the cry of our elders. Muslim homes, Muslim towns, Muslim businesses, Muslim bazaars, Muslim countries. And the hearts are empty of the fikr and the cry of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Insaniyat can go to Jahannam. How we can take their dunya? How we can use them? My dunya must be made. But this worry, that am I looking at them with the cry of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Am I looking at them with the worry of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Why have the hearts been filled with hatred? Why have the hearts been turned against one another? Hearts are in Allah's control. That decision is on our amal. When these hearts didn't cry for what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cried for. When these hearts did not worry for what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam worried for. Understand, my beloved brothers, how can there be khair? How can there be benefit? How can there be peace? How can there be unity when this ummah is not on its object? Aaj ummat maqsad-e-nubuwat se khali ho chuki. Today the ummat has lost the object of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we haven't even got that perception in our hearts. What he gave his whole life for, is that history just to be read? Or just to hear one, two incidents of how he suffered in Taif and how he suffered here and how he, without understanding why? Or just read history of sahaba? Ummat is a collection of different groups whose object is one. If the object is not one, Allah's qasam, it is not an ummat. And those promises of Allah's help, which were promised to this ummat, will never come. Why? Because the quality is not there. What is the quality? The fikr and the worry of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I am not saying it, Quran is saying it, Hadith is saying it. If we want to come out of our deception, if we want to come out of our problem, there is no easy way. It is not that my meals must be on time, my livelihood mustn't get affected, my sleep mustn't get affected, my dunya mustn't get affected, and Allah's deen must come alive. And this ummah must be united. It will never happen. Qurbani has to be given, sacrifice has to be given, and on this, not only will Allah bring deen alive, but our akhirat will be made. Our akhirat will be made, my beloved brothers. And such an akhirat, such decisions, Anas bin Abi Mursid al-Ghanami radiallahu anhu, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asks, Man harisun al-layla, who will guard for one night in the path of Allah? He says, I am ready. one night guarding in the path of Allah. At the time of Fajr, Aina Farisukum al-Layla, where is the horseman of the night? Sahaba say, how was that? He is coming. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked him, Anazalta, did you get down from your horse? He says, besides istinja and tahajjud salah, I guarded for the whole night, I was on my horse. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, Ma alayhi Allah ya'mal abada, from now till he dies, if he doesn't do another amal, Jannat is wajib for him. Jannat is wajib for him. Abu Darda radiallahu anhu goes into his garden. 30 slaves are there. He frees the whole 30. A tabi looks at this and he says, what an amal you have done. How much reward you will get. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, when one slave is freed for each limb of his body, it becomes the replacement and fidya and ransom for your limb from Jahannam. 30 slaves freed one time. What a amal you did. He says, should I not awala adulluka ala afdala min dhalik? Should I not show you something better than this? He asked, what is better than this? Bainama rajulin yasiru ala dabbatihi fi sabilillah wa sawtuhu muallakun bi usbu'ihi idh na'asa na'asa fa saqata sawtuhu falaradatuhu bi sawtihi afdala mimma sana'at. A person is sitting on his horse, he's striving in the path of Allah. He gets tired, he dozes off, his whip is in his hand. When he dozes off, like sometimes we hold a cup of tea, teaspoon is in the hand, we doze off, the teaspoon drops. Get a shock. He's got a whip in his hand, he dozes off, and his whip falls. When his whip falls, he gets a shock. On that shock, Allah will give him more reward than I got freeing 30 slaves. وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. This ummah was sent for this, more than this. More than the reward is the fikr and the cry of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. For this, my beloved brothers, who of us with that conviction in Allah, I have been sent by Allah, I have been selected by Allah, I am not an engineer, I am not a doctor, I am not a lawyer, I am not a businessman, that is all secondary, that is all a necessity. I am the messenger of the messenger of Muhammad, I am the messenger of the Rasul of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I am Allah's safir on this earth. To gain that understanding is not 40 days, 4 months. Allah says, haqqa jihadi, to his haqq. We have to give everything till Allah's deen comes alive on this earth. But as a first step, who of us will say, inshallah, 4 months in the path of Allah? Chalo, bhai, himmat karke bolo. Who will be the first in this majma, inshallah? Chalo, bismillah. 4 months in the path of Allah.
Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar.